Welcome everyone. The topic of this video is Six Linked Inheritance of Lesson Principles of Inheritance and Variation. Six Linked Inheritance can be defined as the inheritance of a trait or character that is determined by a gene located on one of the six chromosomes, which is happened to be X or Y, is called as Six Linked Inheritance. The genes present on the differential region of the X chromosome or the Y chromosome are called as sex linked genes. So the genes present in the differential region of the X chromosome alone are called as X linked genes. And the X linked genes have no corresponding alleles in the Y chromosome. Similarly, the genes present in the differential region of the Y chromosome alone are called as Y linked genes or holandric genes. Holandric genes means they are completely found only in the males and hence they are known as holandric. The Y linked genes have no corresponding allele in the X chromosome. The Y linked genes inherit along with the Y chromosome and they phenotypically express only in the male sex. Sex-linked inherited traits are more common in males than in females because males possess a single X chromosome, a condition known as hemizygous, and therefore express the trait when they inherit one mutant allele. The inheritance of X or Y-linked genes is called as sex-linked inheritance. Inheritance of X-linked genes, in which first we are going to see hemophilia. Hemophilia is commonly known as bleeder's disease, which is more common in men than women. This hereditary disease was first reported by John Cotto in the year 1803. Hemophilia is caused by a recessive gene present in the X chromosome. So a person with a recessive gene in the X chromosome for hemophilia lacks a normal clotting substance called as thromboplastin in blood. Hence, minor injuries causes continuous bleeding leading to death. Females are carriers of the disease and would transmit the disease to 50% of their sons even if the male parent is normal. Hemophilia follows the characteristic crisscross pattern of inheritance. Crisscross pattern of inheritance is a type of inheritance where the characters are transferred from grandmother to granddaughter through her son. Likewise, the characters are transferred from grandfather to the grandson through his daughter. Such a pattern is known as crisscross pattern of inheritance. The second type of disease of X-linked inheritance is color blindness. In human beings, a dominant gene present in the X chromosome is necessary for the formation of color-sensitive cone cells. If the gene is in recessive form, then it is incapable of producing the color-sensitive cone cells. Homozygous recessive females XC and hemizygous recessive males XCY are unable to distinguish red and green color. The inheritance of color blindness can be studied in the following two types of marriages. The first type of marriage is in between a normal female and a colorblind male. Female shows the presence of two X chromosomes. Both these X chromosomes shows the presence of the dominant gene and hence the females are normal. Both the dominant genes, they are represented here as plus sign. The male possesses only one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. The X chromosome shows the presence of the recessive character for colorblind and hence the males are colorblind. The recessive gene here, it is represented as small letter C. The female produces the gametes as X plus, whereas the males produces the gametes as XC and Y. At the time of fertilization, the first gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to produce X plus XC. So because two X chromosomes, the offspring is female, and because it has a dominant gene and a recessive gene, they are carrier. But the dominant gene will suppress the expression of the recessive gene, and hence they are normal. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form X plus and Y, which is happened to be a normal male. So thus in F1 generation, all females are normal, also all males are normal. So F1 females may produce gametes as X plus and XC. The males may produce the gametes as X plus and Y. The first gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to form X plus, which is happened to be a normal female. The first gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form X plus Y, which is happened to be a normal male. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to form X plus and XC, which is happened to be a normal female but carrier. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form XCY, which is happened to be a colorblind male. So thus in F2 generation, all females are happened to be normal, but 50% are happened to be homozygous, whereas the remaining 50% are happened to be heterozygous, which is nothing but normal but carrier. Whereas males happen to be 50% of them are normal and 50% of them are colorblind. The second type of marriage is in between a colorblind female and a normal male. So the female shows the presence of the two recessive genes in both the X chromosomes. Thus, they are colorblind. Whereas in males, the dominant gene is present in the X chromosome, hence they are normal. So the female may produce the gametes of same type, XC, XC. The males may produce the gametes of X plus and Y type. At the time of fertilization, the first gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to form X plus and XC, which is happened to be a normal female but carrier. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form XCY, which is happened to be a colorblind male. So thus in F1 generation, all females are happened to be normal and all males are happened to be colorblind. So the F1 females may produce gametes of two types, X plus and XC, whereas the F1 males may produce gametes of XC and Y type. At the time of fertilization, the first gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to form X plus and XC, which is happened to be a normal female but carrier. The first gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form X plus Y, which is happened to be a normal male. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the first gamete of the male to form XC, XC, which is happened to be a colorblind female. The second gamete of the female may fertilize with the second gamete of the male to form XCY, which is happened to be colorblind male. So thus in F2 generation, all sort of offsprings are formed. For example, normal females and colorblind females, normal males and colorblind males. So thus 50% of the females are normal, 50% of the females are colorblind, 50% of the males are normal, and 50% of the males are colorblind. So with that, the topic sex-linked inheritance is getting over. Regarding the next topic, we'll see in the next video. Thank you.